my channel and welcome to my channel. This is your first time seeing me. Hello, my name is Diamond Janae here on YouTube. If you like hair videos, hair reviews, makeup videos, product reviews, girl talk, chit chats, vlogs, all that fun stuff, definitely consider subscribing to your girl down below and checking out some of my other videos. So as you guys can see by the title, today I'm gonna be doing like a girl talk type of video, kind of like sitting down and kikiing a little bit and whatnot, kind of like an advice type of thing. So yeah, in this particular video, as you guys can see by the title, I'm going to be talking about cuffing season. Like, listen, we all know it's that time of year, okay? I don't know, honest to goodness, I know I'm not crazy, okay? It's something about when it gets slightly colder that all of a sudden I'm just in the mood to just cuddle and just want to have somebody to just chill with and just be romantic and go on cute dates and stuff like that. Like, honest to goodness, like the spring and the summertime, I could care less. I'm like, whatever. Like, your girl's more open and more in the mood to actually like meet somebody and actually like date and stuff like that. Y'all, dating is freaking impossible. Like, y'all don't understand. First of all, I've been done dirty personally. Like, when I think back on the dudes that I would talk to and like the stuff I would put up with, I literally want to slap my younger self. Like, Diamond,
what girl, what were you thinking? What's wrong with you? What were you thinking? Like,
and it's funny too, because some of the guys I used to talk to, I'm still friends with on Facebook, and I just be seeing their life here and there, and I'm just like, wow. Like, sometimes I think to myself, what would have happened if we would have done XYZ? You know what I'm saying? And then I'm just thanking God that it never happened, you know, because you just never know. Like, somebody, like, especially like even like with some of my friends, like when they be going through their relationship drama and stuff like that, I'm like, yeah, y'all can have that. And it's just like, as much as you want to be booed up with somebody, being coupled with somebody, don't sit up here and think that you gotta settle. That's the number one mistake, I'm telling y'all, especially females, because we known for doing this too. We settle for a dude that most, see, and you know what the funny thing is? 9 times out of 10, yo, comment down below if you think I'm wrong or if I'm right. But it's usually the dudes that you kind of overlooked, that you really didn't even feel all like that, but they did something or said something that made you like them. And then in the end, they ended up playing you. And then you're just thinking to yourself, like, dude, like, I didn't even want you in the first place. Like, I gave you a shot, and you're gonna have the audacity to play me? Me?
Stop it. Get some help.
It's just like, don't settle. Honest to goodness, do not settle. Because at the end of the day, listen, I rather, think about it, wouldn't you rather be single, living your best life, and not having to spend money on somebody, and not having to sit up here and deal with heartache, heartbreak, you just looking plain stupid? Like, wouldn't you rather just be by yourself than like that little bit of good nookie? You know what I mean? Like, I don't, honestly, to me, the pros definitely outweigh the cons definitely outweigh the pros when it comes to me thinking about trying to quick grab somebody during cuffing season. Now, granted, it's different if I actually met a guy that's actually worthy of me and is worthy of my time and is actually a good guy and is gonna take me seriously and whatnot. But for me to just pick any old Joe Schmo just because your girl's bored and just because I want to be with somebody, that is definitely not the way to go. Listen, it's sad to say, but we, like, my generation is a very broken generation. Like, we're a generation full of people who have had broken homes, people who, you know, that have been, you know, touched as a kid, you know, not trying to get too sensitive, but like, and very like traumatic life experiences at such a young age. And it's like, my generation, like, I feel like that's another reason why it's so hard to date and to find a good partner, spouse, whatever, is because we're all so broken. Like, I don't understand why therapy isn't more normalized. And I also low-key hate the fact that therapy is so expensive, because I feel like every single person needs to go to therapy for something, whether it's anger issues, whether it's trust issues, etc., etc. Like, our generation is very broken, and we have a very twisted view of love, especially because of the fact that I noticed that like a lot of guys were raised in households with single mothers because their dad skipped out on them. So guess what? The dude's not really gonna know how to be a proper man because he didn't have that father figure in his life. And guess what? Most likely he's gonna be a player, not take girls seriously, treat them like objects, and end up getting 5 different girls pregnant before they turn to age 25. You know what I mean? Like, I feel as though this generation is so caught up on couple goals. Like, don't even get me started on couple channels here on YouTube. I'm sorry. Y'all can call me a hater, whatever, but honest to goodness, I do not care for couple channels whatsoever because it's like, it's such a fake facade because for the most part, you only see their ups. You don't see their downs. Like, I know some people that their relationships look so cute, so good on social media, but then when they're at home, it's chaos. And it's just like, look at the full picture. Like, it's really not all that cracked up to be. So it's just like, nah, like, don't settle. Now, granted, if you do happen to meet somebody, you're interested in them, yeah, take that chance. Go on a date, do something. But at the same time, that first red flag that pops up,
cut it off.
At the end of the day, if you get to a point where you're putting somebody before yourself, especially if you had like literally just met that person, that's a red flag. Like, if you know that you're the type of person that you're really sensitive and you get attached to people easily, don't you dare sit up here and go, because most of the time people will show their true colors, I will say, within the first day of you meeting them. Like, there's just certain things that just give away certain things. Like, if you really sit there and don't brush nothing under the rug, you're gonna start seeing like warning signs. Like, even like when I first started talking to this one guy I dated, like, I think it was like closer to 3 years ago, like, there was already a red flag that this guy was trying to be a rapper. I specifically always told myself, I will never, ever, I don't care how cute you are, how successful you are, I'm never dating a rapper. Look what happened. I settled. Like, I told myself I would never date a rapper, I would never date a SoundCloud rapper on top of that, and lo and behold, your girl settled. And guess what happened? I ended up wasting 6 months of my life with this guy that I wasn't even 100% happy with, but because I loved the fact that I was in a relationship and I always chill with him every weekend and that was like our thing, I got so accustomed to that, I liked the idea of him more than I actually liked him. And that's the issue, because especially as females, we tend to want to fix dudes and we tend to want to take care of them and change them and better them. At the end of the day, sis, if he's not going to change for himself, what makes you think he's going to change for you? I'm sorry. Yeah, you have those extremely rare cases that a guy will change for you, but how much hurt and heartache and how many times is he going to cheat on you for him to actually want to change and realize that? Sorry, it's a hard pill to swallow, but the sooner you accept it and the sooner you actually learn from it and stop going to those same type of toxic people that are just gonna suck the life and the energy out of you, you're never gonna grow, you're still gonna be unhappy, you're not gonna enjoy life, you're gonna continue to be heartbroken, you're gonna continue to feel lonely. Why? Because you feel as though that you need to be in a relationship to be happy, and that's not the case at all. I don't know who this video's for, but I know it's for somebody because I felt as though I needed to make this video for a reason. So with all that craziness being said, this cuffing season, ladies and some fellas, be very careful and please do not dig into the hype. It is not that big of a deal. It is not that bad to be single during the holidays, especially, oh my gosh, especially my particular generation. If you are under the age of 28, please don't sit up here and think that you have to be married and have kids by the time you're 25. That is not the wave. You can be independent and have your own stuff. And like, no, I feel like, especially in this generation, again, like, people just think that, oh, I'm supposed to be married right away, I'm supposed to have kids by now. Like, oh, people I went to high school with, they have their boyfriends or their husbands and they have kids and I'm still single. Like, no, trust me, those thoughts have crossed my mind here and there. I'm just like, dang, like, your girl's still single. But at the same time, it is what it is. I do know that me waiting and being patient and not just snagging up anybody, because trust me, dudes be hitting me up in my inbox more on Instagram than Facebook, I will say. But regardless, it's just like, do you honestly think I'm gonna sit up here and be flattered just because you said I was cute? Like, you gotta bring something else. Like, you definitely gotta hold yourself to that higher standard and that higher regard and have that self-confidence and be like, you know what, I'm the ish. So if you want to sit up here and try to talk to me, you gotta bring something more to the table than just, hey, beautiful. You know what I mean? Like, I feel like a lot of females get too hyped up over that. Like, okay, like, he said you're pretty. And? Like, and I'm not saying this to sound, like, stuck up or anything like that. I'm saying that because, again, hold yourself to a higher regard, because at the end of the day, the way you carry yourself and the way you view yourself, that's gonna reflect who's coming after you. But yeah, with all that craziness being said, this cuffing season, just please, 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 I am begging you, okay? Be smarter with your choices, and also who do you decide to pick.